Fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests, good evening to all of you. How many of you are in current level are at the choice of your career? How many of you? Raise your hands, please. How many of you are at the choice of your career that you want to be loved what you want to be? Great. Only 3, 4, so 5, great. Thank you so much. Today, the topic of my presentation is career counseling in Pakistan. It's a qualitative study that has been conducted in Pakistan, in Islamabad. I just want to tell all of you that how it is important and how it benefits to the persons in his career path. This qualitative study was conducted by Atif Iqbal and Dr. R. K. Malik, both were from Zavist Islamabad, and this has been published. This was published in Developing Country Studies, IISTI, and its ISS number is 2246078. This is the journal which is available online. And the number ISS is allocated to those studies which have been internationally recognized. So this study is internationally recognized study. So look at what is actually the career counseling is. The goal of study is, or was, to identify and understand the importance and availability and practicality of career counseling in Pakistan. And then number two, to know the importance of career counselor and the influence on career choice. So this was the objective of the study. I'm a little bit further because of the time constraint. So the study background was that education prepares us for the career path that we have to choose for our next career. And the second, having proper career counseling will impact to the person's life or the career choice. So this is the definition of career counseling, what it is as per the Oxford Dictionary, a process by which a counselor, a qualified person, or an experienced person which interacts with the person to know about his career choices and scheme of studies or the plan of studies that will impact on his future career. So this is the definition of that study. Objective of study was 4 to 5 objectives, but the main objective we discussed to know the importance of career counseling and the impact of career counseling on someone's career choice. So this is the detail of respondent. There were only 25 participants, which reflects their gender, their demographics, their education, their status, and their age. So this was the number of the participants. On the right side, you can see the number of the participants for a qualitative studies was designed up to the international level and up to the international standard, because it was suggested by the authorities that a 25, more than 6%, 225% is enough number of participants for an study. So this is the area where they work. Some are from the arts, some were from the banking, some were from the finance, some were from the HRM and so on. So different sectorial people were involved in that study. The interview respondent for 20 to 30 minutes, and there was initially on their demographic, and then wholly on the specific subject that was career counseling. I'm sorry, this is a little bit bigger size. This is 3 on the career counseling. What the questions have been made. The main important questions were that have you ever been taught at your school level on career counseling, at university level, at college level? Have you got any career counseling training? Who has suggested you, or the person you are in current career, or the career of your choice? So these were some questions. So the response for the persons was 60% of the participants replied that there was no career counseling have been received by them. 60% of the of the persons responded, they did not receive any career counseling. Like your group was also suggested, I can assume that more than 90% or 80% in this group didn't receive any career counseling by anyone. At few of our participants have noticed. 30% participants responded that they were guided by their teachers, and 10% by their parents, and 10% said that they were guided by their teachers. So these were the reasons why the people are in the current careers. Majority of the persons were saying that they have been asked by their parents. Fewer responded that my friend was going to that scheme of study, and fewer the cultural constraints as well, like the women cannot study in some specific subjects due to cultural barriers. So these were the reasons that they have chosen their career. Availability of career counseling. When this question was asked by the participants, so 12% said yes, and 13 says no. At a school level, 5% said yes, and 20% says no. College level, 7%, 18%, and university level, 8%, 17%. You can see the figure. So when this question was asked that did you get career counseling at school, college, or university level, all the participants says no. That means there is no any career counseling set up in our educational institutions. Why it's not done? I'm sorry. So when we asked that, does it exist? Does career counseling exist in Pakistan? All the participants replied with no. And this was, we have already discussed what influence you have been taken by the participants, that which things were that you have been in your career counseling, like parents says, like my family says, like my friend says. Importance of career counseling. 88% of the respondents say that it is highly important. And 12% said that it is important, but it does not emphasize on the specialization of the implementation. So the crux of the study is that there is a crucial need of career counseling in the institutions of Pakistan. Thank you so much.